Now what we're going to do is we're going to find the x-intercepts. To find the x-intercepts, what we're going to do is we're going to take P of x, or the top polynomial, and set it to 0 and find out where it hits the x-axis. So we have x plus 3 is equal to 0, so x equals negative 3. So my one and only x-intercept is going to be at negative 3, comma 0. Next step, what we're going to do is find the behavior as x approaches each asymptote. So to find the behavior as x approaches the vertical asymptote, what I've got to do is I've got to figure out what happens on either side. So this notation is x approaches, that's what the arrow means, negative 1, and I've got to approach it from both sides. So this little negative up here means that I'm going to approach it from the left-hand side. When I'm looking at the behavior as I approach the asymptote, what I really want to do is I want to find out what the sign of my function is at the end. I don't care what the number is particularly, I want to know what the sign is. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose a number that's on the left-hand side of negative 1, but really close to it still. So I'm going to use negative 1.1. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the negative 1.1 into my original function, and all I care about is what the sign is for each one of these. I don't care what the actual number is, I just want to know what the sign is. So if I put in a negative 1.1 into x plus 3, replace the x with it, I'm going to end up with a positive number there. If I put in a negative 1.1 into this part of the function, I'm going to end up with a negative number. If I put in a negative 1.1 into x plus 1, I am also going to end up with a negative number. So I'll have a negative times a negative, which is a positive, divided into a positive, so the answer is positive. What that means for our graph is that it will, as we approach that asymptote, it will go up. It will go to a positive, the output will be a positive infinity. So now I've got to see what happens when x approaches negative 1 from the right-hand side. So I'm going to choose a number close to negative 1, but not negative 1. So I have negative 0.9. Again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to find out what the sign is of my original function if I put in a negative 0.9. If I put in negative 0.9 on the top, I'm going to get a positive number. If I put in a negative 0.9 into this portion of it, I'm going to get a negative number. If I put in a negative 0.9 into this portion of it, I am going to get a positive number. So my answer, I have a negative times a positive, which is a negative, divided into a positive, is a negative number. That means that as I approach the asymptote on the right-hand side, I will have a very large negative number. As x approaches the vertical asymptote, the other vertical asymptote we have is 5. So as x approaches 5 from the left-hand side, I'm going to put in a number that is on the left side of 5, but really close to it. So I'm going to choose 4.9. Choosing 4.9, I'm going to put it into my top portion and I'm going to get a positive number. 4.9 right there is going to give me a negative number. And 4.9 right here will give me a positive number. So I end up with a positive divided by a negative, which is a negative number. And so what that means is as my graph approaches 5 from the left-hand side, it's going to produce a very large negative number. As x approaches 5, from the right-hand side, I have f of 5.1, is what I'm going to look at this time. Putting in 5.1 into my top, I'm going to get a positive number. 5.1 into this factor, I'm going to get a positive number. 5.1 into this factor, I'm also going to get a positive number. So my end result is going to be a positive number, which means as I approach my asymptote from the right-hand side, I'll end up with a very large positive number. The last thing we have to do is find the behavior as x approaches the tails of my graph. So I need to know what's happening as my graph goes out to negative infinity and infinity. Will it approach my horizontal asymptotes? Will it approach my horizontal asymptotes from the top? will approach my horizontal asymptotes from the bottom. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose a very large negative number. So I'm going to choose negative 1,000. So I put in a negative 1,000 into my original function. So I get a negative 1,000 plus 3 over a negative 1,000 minus 5. And then you're going to put in a negative 1,000 plus 1. And you're going to get your calculator out, and you're going to figure out what exactly this value is. When you get your calculator out, you're going to end up with a negative 0.0009 for this portion if I put in a negative 1,000. What that means is I will be below my x-axis. And you're going to do it for the other side. F of 1,000 is equal to 1,000 plus 3 divided by 1,000 minus 5 and 1,000 plus 1. And it's going to be some very small, we'll say 0.0009. That means that it's a positive value and it's going to be above the x-axis. And the reason I care about the x-axis in particular is remember that our asymptote is at y equals 0, which is the x-axis. Remember, our asymptote again is at y equals 0, which is the x-axis. So now what we're ready to do is we're ready to graph this. So we're going to pull in all the information that we have. So what we know from step 1 and 2 produces step number 3, which is where our asymptotes are. We have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 1. We also have another vertical asymptote at x equals 5. We have our horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. We have our y-intercept at 0 and negative 3/5. We have an x-intercept at negative 3. And we know the behavior as x approaches the tails, which is out here, the negative infinity and the positive infinity. We also know the behavior as x approaches each one of these asymptotes. So as x approaches this tail, we know that we're below here. As x approaches this asymptote from the left-hand side, we knew it was a positive number, so it's going to go to positive infinity. We know as x approaches negative 1 from the right-hand side, we ended up with a negative number, so we know it's going to negative infinity. We know as x approaches 5 from the left-hand side, it also was a negative number, so it goes to negative infinity. And as x approaches the 5 from the right-hand side, it was a positive number, so we know it's positive infinity. And as x approaches the positive infinity on, as we go further and further out, that we know that it happened to be a positive number, so it's going to be above the x-axis, or above, in my case, the asymptote. So now what we're going to do is we're going to bring all this information together. I usually start on the left-hand side and work my way right. I know that I need a cross right here. I know that I'm going to approach my asymptote from the bottom. And I know I need to start here. So what I do is I just connect the dots. So that's what that one looks like. Looking here in the middle, I know I'm going to start here, I'm going to end here, and I need a cross right there. So that's what that middle piece looks like. On this end, I know that I'm going to start here, I need to end here, I don't cross anywhere on the x-axis, and so there's my graph. We have now successfully graphed a rational function.